Welcome back. We are trying again to shed light about the Egyptian-Russian meeting between President Sisi and Russian President Vladimir Putin, as well as Egypt's participation for the Russian-Africa Summit and the Economic Forum in Sochi. To shed more light, we are joined over the phone by Dr. Hussein Shuraiba, Professor of Political Planning. Dr. Shuraiba.
How are you, ma'am?
How are you, sir? Doctor, His Excellency President Sisi, in his speech at the first Russian-African Summit and Economic Forum, asserted on the importance of enhancing means of cooperation between Moscow and the Black Continent and pushing forward the 2063 development process. How do you see that?
Well, I see that they are doing business, that's all. I see Russia is in need to business because recession is worldwide and it's covering everywhere. Which parts of the world need to, let's say, the new technology, the new know-how, the updated tools for infrastructures? Russia is one of the countries worldwide is there. So this summit and this meeting is a win-win. And by the way, I would like to thank President Vladimir Putin for putting back again Russia as another leader in the world of economy, because it was solely alone from before with Europe and United States. And right now we do have Russia, and we do have China, and we do have United States, and we do have Europe. So this is will give us, as Africans, a balance of choosing and getting the best from the way of working with any one of them. So it's not for the sake of Russia, and it's very expensive, I would go for this, or for less updated things, I would go to Europe, or no, I will pick up the updated with the best competing prices, with the best welfare of the people of African countries.
Yes.
And that's the important part of this.
Yes. Sir, how do you see the importance of such a conference, which is held for the first time in Sochi, Russia, for both the African states and Russia? How do you see the future of integration and economic cooperation and trade investment between Russia and the African states? How do you see the future of economic cooperation, sir?
My dear, you said the first, and this is the first. Why it was the beginning of the word first? Because there is some people are keen about Africa. Who are the leader right now of Africa? It's President Sisi. He's keen not about the winning of his country, Egypt, but he is thinking a positive things for all African countries. This is why when this idea came up and brought to notice, and Africa knows that Egypt is doing the welfare of their countries.
Indeed.
So they went with Egypt to do this.
Yes.
And before, nobody have done this for them. And the second thing, when you found that Russia, there is a kind of inflation and business is dropping down, whether in Asia and even in Europe, as well as the United States, this type of business will really give them some kind of a business opportunity, and this will help them. The high tech will be presented to Africa in a very reasonable, decentable, and respectable way of win-on-win projects.
Yes.
It is not going to be win for Russia and lose for Africa. It will be win for Russia, win for Africa.
Yes.
The other thing, when you have to know that Africa has lots of resources.
Indeed.
These resources are, until today, is not will, let's say, develop. And it needs the know-how, the updated technology to go and do this. When you find that you are you can produce electric power from the solar panels in Africa, and this is available for them 24/7, 365 days. They can supply anywhere electricity in Africa with no wires and everything, because most of it is still jungles and safaris and all these things. So you can supply the electric power over there with a very reasonable prices, as well as this will give them an opportunity for clean electric power. The other thing, when you found that you have electric power, you can also generate other projects, such as whatever you name it, on dairy products, which people are in need to it on daily basis. Clean water can be submitted and given to every part of in Africa. Food industrial would go and growth of this, and even sold out of Africa to, because it is natural, not use any type of chemicals or so this would be a kind of a plus to Africa, and they are selling their product outside, so their currency would be stable, because most of the African countries, their currency are not stable at all.
Yes. Dr. Shuriba, from your point of view, what has the Sochi summit got to offer to the African leaders and their states? And as you have kindly mentioned now, that the balance here is different than before. We want somehow to reach here a win-win situation. What are the concrete steps on the ground that could be taken in order to reach that?
Well, the Russian Federation banks will be ready to even fund some of these projects. They will be ready to accept some of the raw materials, because most of the African product is raw. So they are accepting raw materials from Africa to Russia back again. Russia, you know, we are depending, part of our army vessels and all these things is from Russia, part of it. So the African countries, they would be using also some part of this from Russia, and they would be giving them on a very reasonable prices, as well as the way of installment, and some of it would be like a kind of a gift from Russia Federation. Putin is trying to bring back Russia into its power worldwide. This is very well known, and he's trying to with China to be everywhere where they can be another solid power available against what you call, it's not against, but it is will match the United States as well as in Europe. They are in Africa. So this is a balance of economy. A balance of the economy is a plus to Africa. It's not a minus to it. It is a plus. Until they have enough what they have needed from development in their countries, I think they will start, you know, limiting whatever, whether from the States, Europe, and Asia also.
Indeed, Dr. Hussein Shuraiba, Professor of Political Planning, always a pleasure to listen to your input, sir. Thank you very much. And still with our special coverage, where President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and Russian President Vladimir Putin met to discuss enhancing bilateral relations in all fields and all levels within the framework of the Comprehensive Partnership and Strategic Cooperation Agreement signed between the two countries. President Sisi also will meet with a number of African leaders attending the summit, and will participate in launching the Afro-Russian Economic Forum, which aims to develop trade cooperation and economic relations between Russia and Africa. More details in the following story.
President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi visit to Russia opens new important horizons for relations between the two countries, particularly at the level of bilateral and regional cooperation. The head of state's visit is going to be his fifth to Russia since his first visit as Minister of Defense in 2014 and the 12th meeting with President Vladimir Putin over this period. President Sisi's visit to Russia is mainly for holding the Russian-African summit, as President Sisi currently chairs the African Union, which is attended by African leaders and heads of major African organizations. The two-day summit held in Sochi is expected to include the signing of several agreements and the aim at improving the lives of Africans and establishing peace. As for Egyptian-Russian relations, Russia is one of Egypt's largest trade partners, as trade between them witnessed a remarkable growth in 2018, hitting around $7.66 billion. Egypt's exports to Russia increased by 4.2% in 2018, registering around $526.4 million, compared with $505.6 million in 2017. An increase in Egypt's exports to Russia is noted, and the increase includes agricultural crops, industrial products. Egypt plans to increase exports to reduce large trade deficit between the two countries. The two leaders will tackle a number of regional issues, especially related to the Gulf region, Syria, Libya, and Yemen. Egyptian-Russian historical relations flourished in the 1950s and the 60s, but they date back to much earlier.